Everything all right? Everything sound all right? You guys doing all right?
All right.
Oh, thanks, sir. If I had my hat on, I'd have to have windshield wipers on these glasses. I'm sweating like I'm running from somebody. So we're here for the music tonight, not my ugly face. That song right there was a new song that we're going to be working on an album called One Thing Wrong. This song right here is one that I wrote with Mr. Cody Jinks, and who had two stars to go on this next album, and I found out last week that it didn't make the new album. So I told him I'm going to go ahead and record it. The whole premise of me wanting to record this song is that I wrote the first two verses in a traffic jam, and I just kind of felt like it was something he could do at Red Rocks. It had this sound to it for that. So I sent it to him, and he wrote the chorus and the last verse, and it came together as a really cool song. But whenever I pitched it to him, I told him, I said, I'll bet you that this thing will get a hit. This will be a hit song if you record this thing. And if it isn't, then I'll wash your tour bus with a toothbrush. And I kind of feel like since he didn't record it, he's backing out of a bet. Yeah, wash my Jeep. I borrowed his van once because my bus had broke, my RV had broke down. And "You Suck" was keyed in the side of his van. So I thought I'd be the nice guy and wash his van. Apparently, they'd never washed that van, and he was real upset about it. He was like, "Why did you wash the van? Nobody washes the van." Yeah, I was like, "You should put that somewhere," because I was raised that when you borrow something, you fill up the tank and you give it to them cleaner when they got it. So that backfired. So now people are pissed because I don't wash their vehicles when I bring them back. But I thought this is a really great song, and I felt like it was something necessary for the times these days, and it's a voice for everybody. One thing that I've had a real struggle with in the last month or two is I've been writing with artists here in Texas, and I've been writing with artists in Nashville, and I've friends with artists that have written hits for Al Dean, and I got friends down here that think Al Dean should go to hell, and I hate the line that's being drawn in music and art, because I left the TV and news, turned it off, with the separation that's causing in the country, and now I'm seeing it in the music, so it's just breaking my heart. So I felt like this song needed to be out there through somebody. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Well, that leather jacket don't make you an outlaw. That long hair, it don't mean that you smoke weed. And those boots and hat don't mean you're a cowboy. And ain't a damn thing makes you better than me. Well, those tattoos, they don't make you a wild one. That nose ring, it don't make you a freak. That guitar, it don't make you no picker lord. No, ain't a damn thing makes you better than me. Better than me. Lord, that's all I wanna be. I'm tired of running round in circles, pretending to be free. Better than me, Lord, it ain't that hard, who knew? Sounds like what you need to get down to is being better than you. That suit and tie don't make you no wise man. That bank account won't matter, you'll soon see. And that Bible, it don't mean you're going to heaven, no. Ain't a damn thing makes you better than me. Oh, better than me. That's all I wanna be. I'm tired of running in circles, pretending to be free, better than me. Lord, it ain't that hard, who knew? Sounds like what you need to get down to. It's been better than you. Circles, pretending to be free, better than me. Lord, it ain't that hard, who knew? Sounds like what you need to get down to. It's being better than you. Better. Mighty fine, mighty fine. I hope that song sells, makes me $1 million. I'll give half to my ex, the other half to my wife, and break even as usual.